السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Now welcome to our lecture on the International Nuclear and Radiological Events Scales, INES for short. In today's world, where nuclear power plants and radiological facilities play a significant role in our energy production and medical advancement, it's circular to have a standardized system to assess and communicate the severity of nuclear and radiological incidents. That is where INES comes into a play. The International Atomic Engineer Agency, IAEA, developed the International Nuclear Radiological Event Scales in 1990 as a tool for promptly communicating information about nuclear and radiological events to the public, media, and authorized scales provides common language to allow us to understand the potential consequence of such incident. The answer is a seven levels, which it have a seven levels to. Seven levels that is categorizes events based on their impact on people, where and the environment. It ranges from level one, which is anomaly, which it's represented as anomaly with no safety signification, to level seven, which it's signification a major accident with widespread health on and environment effects. This each levels has specific certificate that determined its classification. This critical includes factors such as radiation levels, release of radioactive materials, impact on worker health, environmental consequence, and contamination of taking. By using this scale, is authorized can be quickly assess the severity of an incident and take appropriate actions to protect people safety. It also helps in international cooperation by providing a common understanding among the countries when it share information about nuclear radiological. Therefore, we will use the exposure each level for each this is instance in details. We will discuss real life examples for this radiation, for this incident that is have occurred and various levels and examining the lessons learned. Where is the International Nuclear Radiological Events, INES, with a was established by INES, International Atomic Energy Agency, and it can be incident and accident nuclear facilities are divided by into several categories according to its severity each country determines the severity of the incident or accident using this scale of amount. The accident, like the accident from tobacco, which it can be tobacco Fukushima in Japan, which was be provisional rate number 7, and it's indicated that it was the most serious accident because of the amount of radioactive material release. But what is the effect for the reactor accident? For reactor accident, it's if an emergency happens in a nuclear facility and the radioactive gas leaks from the nuclear facilities, it's full of the into the atmosphere, a state called plume. Plume may be contain a radioactive gas material, radioactive noble gases, and the particulates such as radioactive iodine or cesium-137. Radioactive noble gases like krypton or xenon, which are not deposited on the ground, and even if they enter the human body through the inhalation, they don't be remain in the body. However, people receive radiation emitted from radioactive material contains in a plume passing the overhead. This results in the external exposure. This is in the external exposure. A radioactive iodine, which is iodine 137, and cesium 137 are deposited on the ground surface, and while a plume passes. So therefore, external exposure from the deposit radioactive material may be occur even after the plume has passed. Internal exposure can be also occur if one directly inhales radioactive material while plume passes, or if one consumes drinking water or foods contaminated with deposit radioactive material. For protected, the product of the nuclear reactor, we have a light water, which is the light water nuclear reactor is currently the most waste type for reactor around the world, also which used in the like in the Fukushima bomb. Bittering, inhaling the uranium, with uranium 235, which is 3 to 5% uranium 238, and 96% with a neutron results in a nuclear fission. Radioactive nuclear fissions, it's produced such as iodine 131 and cesium 137 and strontium 19 are created in this process. When uranium 236-38 is bombarded with neutrons, in plutonium it can be plutonium 239. It's a created. Cesium 134 is not created directly from nuclear fission of uranium 235 through beta disintegration, which for xenon 133 is and the light, which is our nuclear fission produces a cesium disintegrate for cesium 133. And then turn into a cesium 134 4 and emission gamma ray, which is a decelerated of neutrons are trapped. As long as the reactor is working properly through the products remains in nuclear fuel rods and don't leak out of the reactor. Nuclear facilities are equipped with a variety of machines for the preventing leaks of radioactive material. But if they all stopped functions, probably radioactive leaks will occur. Radioactive material derived from the type of four types of radioactive material. Iodine-137 and cesium-134, cesium-137 and iodine-131 and strontium-19 are a major concern in relation to health and environmental effects of radioactive material release onto the environment due to the accident to Fukushima accident. While various other materials were also released, they are known to have shorter half-life than this our four type or have been released in the negligible amounts. Iodine-131 has a short half-life time, which is merely 8 days, but accumulates once it enters body, it's 10 to 30% will be accumulated in the thyroid. If this happens, the thyroid will be contained to be locally exposed beta particles and gamma rays for a while. Two types for radioactive cesium, cesium-134 and cesium-137 are the major causes for contamination due to the nuclear plant accident. Cesium-137 has a long half-life time, 30 years, and contains to contaminate in the environment for a long time, since radioactive cesium has similar chemical properties for potassium, and it will be distributed throughout the body. Like potassium, the biological half-life for cesium and the iodine, are very depending on the age of the person and are known to become shorter to younger the person is. Strontium-19 has a long half-life time. It's mainly 50 years. It enters the body, it accumulates in bodies because it has a chemical property similar to calcium. Since it does not emit gamma ray, it is not easy as in the case of calcium of cesium-137 and cesium-134, because to detect where the and how much exists in the body. A nuclear plant accident, strontium-19 is also produced as a result of nuclear fission. This similar of quantity of cesium-137 and cesium-139, it's emitted a plutonium-239 and the light derived from the accident from the Fukushima, its but detected amount as are almost equal to the result of the measuring considering to over Japan before the accident. Compares between the estimated amount released radionuclides between the Chernobyl and the Fukushima details. In this table, we have A comparison between the major radioactive material released onto the environment due to the Chernobyl accident and the Fukushima in Japan. Among them, cesium-137, cesium-134, and cesium-137 are the major radionuclides that is called both health facilitator. In this table shows the melting and boiling point, melting point, and the therefore the gas state when the nuclear fall for the molten state melting point, it's equal 2,000% degree. When the cesium is in gas state, the release into the atmosphere, it goes into the liquid state when the temperature within the contaminated vessels dropped below to the boiling point, and it's further become particular as temperature below to its melting point 28 degree. Thus, cesium is mostly particular forms in the atmosphere and will be diffused over wind areas by wind. This was wrote how radioactive cesium was separated in the two distinct areas in the Fukushima decreation. Also, it is a different to directly compares to release amount between the Chernobyl accident and the Fukushima accident, because it is the largest amount released at the time in the Chernobyl accident is considered to have been partly due to the fact to the core exposed and was directly exposed to the temperature atmosphere. The it contracted relative small amount released from the Fukushima as extensive destruction of the contaminated vessels was barely avoided, making it possible to curb at temperature directly and reduce leak of the release time. However, some noble gases like xenon and cryptium are easily released onto the atmosphere and are considerable to have been released also from the reactor from 2A Fukushima. Finally, we have the accident that is the core at the time of accident considered to have been caused released to large amount for gases in the Fukushima. And thank you for attention, and we will be complete in the next lecture.